All right, there was another mass shooting, this time in Florida. 17 people were killed by a teenager who was expelled from the high school a year earlier. Now, apparently, this kid showed plenty of signs of being troubled. He was expelled from the school. We don't know exactly why. This kid made certain threats online. He went on to YouTube at one point and posted a message on the channel saying that I'm going to be a professional school shooter or something like that. The YouTuber contacted the FBI. So the authorities knew that this guy was a problem person. Anyway, this guy proceeded to show up at the school. He pulled a fire alarm and used the opportunity to shoot innocent people. One teacher actually died shielding several students from the gunfire. So I want to talk about what we can do to reduce the likelihood of mass shootings. I mean, first, can we stop mass shootings? Of course, you have a lot of Democrats talking about gun control and things like that. Here's the deal. We've had gun control in pro-gun states, anti-gun states. We've had mass shootings and other events happen in places like Norway, where we had dozens and dozens of people were killed in one particular incident. France obviously had a number of terrorist attacks. They've had shootings before. Mass shooting events. California, which is a pretty big pro-gun, big gun control state with a lot of restrictions against firearms. Obviously, that didn't help with the incident, the incidents that happened there. So, gun control doesn't seem to be effective in stopping these events. I don't think we can ever really stop it. I think we need the best we can do is really increase security and really look into the root issue. Okay, for our security, it doesn't make any sense to have a situation where you're preventing teachers from getting proper training and being able to carry firearms to protect themselves and their students. Doesn't make any sense to prevent staff members from getting specialized training and actually being able to get a concealed carry permit and carry on campus. Doesn't make a lot of sense. I mean, bad guys are going to go onto campus and kill innocent people. I mean, simply preventing law-abiding citizens from protecting themselves won't resolve that issue. It doesn't make anybody any safer. If anything, it makes people a target because they know that, you know, if they start shooting, they can have a bigger effect because there's less people there to really defend themselves. So some practical things we can do is allow teachers to carry concealed carry permits and get specialized training. We can also put more armed security guards in schools. I never understood the concept of unarmed security guards in places where, you know, bad guys will want to hit. School resource officers. A lot of districts don't want to spend the money on hiring a police officer to go into certain areas at certain schools and just play an active role in the security at the school. Those are some practical things we can do. Other things, as far as the root of the problem, we have a lot of young men without leadership, without guidance, who are disturbed. We have a lot of young men who don't have access to a positive role model. And a lot of these young men, they fall through the cracks, and there's some mental health issues. So I think we can expand the students' access to mental health, but mental health services. But that's going to be expensive. That's going to cost money, and a lot of school districts don't want to spend that type of money. They can't afford to spend that type of money. But it is an option. I think that sort of gets a little bit closer to the root of the problem. I think freshman orientation. I think they should have mentoring programs. I was actually a part of a mentorship program where we actually hooked up the incoming freshmen with adult mentors, community leaders, showing these kids a better way of making decisions, just a better life, better lifestyle. And then we also linked them up with upperclassmen, positive upperclassmen who really wanted to help these younger freshmen coming in. So I think the whole idea behind that program I was working in, it was to basically give the incoming freshmen ownership in the culture of the school, ownership in the school, so they're more likely to stick around and stay in the system. If they feel like they're actually a part of something, they're more likely to really participate and really more likely to stick with it. So those are some of the things I think we can really do in mentorship programs. I also think expansion of mental health services. Those are some things that we can do in schools. And of course, armed security, school resource officers, things like that. The thing is, this stuff costs money. And a lot of schools don't have it. So share your thoughts. What can we do to prevent or stop mass shootings? Or can they ever be prevented? I mean, I think as long as you have choice, human beings, or some person's always going to make a bad choice. Always going to be some people willing to do evil, to harm other people. It's always going to be evil in the world. So the best we can do is really reduce the evil that the person can do. So thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.